Good people, good people, good people. Yeah, welcome to Awesome Forex again. And it is weekend as usual. Therefore, it is a very clean day for us to discuss the structure of the market, the probable direction for the coming week. And yeah, we have gold here. So we're going to have a quick outlook on gold. Now, what we have to expect maybe next week. So that's the target of this. But before that, remember we have a free signal service as usual, a free signal in our Telegram channel. Free signal. We share things, eh? We share chats, and also we share those signals as usual, like this. This was our last signal. So if you have not maybe joined this program, make sure that you join, because we expect next week also to do the same thing. And we had this 4-week report. We have a 4-week report on this. From all the 4 weeks, we had a total of 12 signals, and we have lost only 2 signals. So we are in 83.3% win rate. That's very, very big. So make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel, and also you join our what we call our Telegram channel. Then we have our Facebook page. So in all platforms, it's where we share our basic information. So now let's go. Now this is gold, gold precious metal in a weekly time frame. Now I'm going to discuss a few things here, whereby in a weekly time frame we see those candlestick formations. Now the very important thing is candlestick formations, whereby we have those rejection candles, and now this week also we had this indecision. It is something like an indecision, like candlestick that has got a very reduced body. But last week we had the rejection. Now this shows that we have buyers at this area. Now clearly forward, this shows that we have buyers at this region. So we can expect that price will go up from this area. That's just an overview. Now to support this, we have this trend line. Now probably it has faded out. I can put this maybe in this color, or maybe to differentiate it. Now we have this trend line that was rejected. Now price, it is playing with that trend line. Now it is playing with that trend line. So now one important idea about trend lines, about support and resistance. Now always, most people, if you have this, let's say this is your trend line, I mean this is your, let's say, resistance. So we have idea that when the price comes there, hits this, goes away, comes again. So people always, they understand that all the time price is going to do something like that. So that's not true. Always what you're supposed to understand is when the price is at a zone, don't take any action until price shows a specific direction from that zone. So if it is playing with this trend line, we cannot generally say that all price is going to bounce at this trend line. No, it is possible also to break it down. So we have to watch the action of market until it leave that trend line and move away. So probably it may leave moving away to the upside, or it may break and moving away to the downside. So we have to watch this area. But adding other factors of confluence, when we add other factors of confluence at the current trend line here, it shows a high probability of price bouncing before breaking it. So it will shortly bounce up. It is not just a total movement to the upside. No, it's just a short-term bounce to the upside, and then later it will come to the trend line, break it, and move into the downside. So that is just an overview of what's going on here. And also we add other things like order block idea. We have an idea of an order block. Now for those who know trading order block, always I talked about this in previous videos. I explained that always there is an order block. I think in daily time frame you can see it clearly later. Now always there was an order block that was created here during order flow to the upside. Now this is in a day, not in a week. Now it is clearly in a day and 4 hours. Now price created an order block, so it moved up, then it has come again to the order block. So order block, those are the regions where price may bounce going back to where it came from, or sometimes it may break. So we have different types of order blocks. So this order block may play any role price is going to consolidate at this region, but later may break to the upside or to the downside. So also this gives us a clue about maybe price is going to bounce to the upside, but also we'll add other things later. Then as we go to lower time frames, we'll come up with a clear idea about direction of the market in the coming week. So now I can add something there. We have this structure here. Or maybe we can turn this into line chart. So now turning this into line chart, now you'll find that it is forming a sort of head and shoulder, pattern. Now we don't have that clear shoulder on this side now. So what we expect is next week price probably will be forming the next shoulder here. Probably may form a clear next shoulder. Also, this is additional factor of confidence on upward movement of market or price in the coming week. Let's go to the daily time frame. Now, in a daily time frame, we can discuss a few things. We already have those wave counts and everything. So it's just a continuation of what maybe we already not see in the past weeks. So it's just a continuation. Market has not yet deviated from our projection. So now we had those wave counts and everything. But one main thing that I'm going to talk here in daily time frame, mainly let's watch about this, a bullish engulfing somewhere there. A sort of bullish engulfing, or sometimes it is a railway track. But I think this bullish candle is a little bit longer than the previous one. So now this candlestick formation here, and it is at the zone, a trend line as usual. It is at a zone, a trend line is passing there. So this also gives a confluence, and it has not yet broken. Now remember that. Price has not yet moved beyond this formation here. So this formation is still in function, so it is still in influence about this upward movement we expect maybe to take place in the coming week, or a few days maybe of the coming week. It may have a short upward move to the downside and everything. Now so always this is very clear and very clean in a daily time frame. So moving to 4 hours, probably I can have a wave count now to support what I say. I can have wave counts is very important. Wave counts is very important. Maybe this order block, it is still in function, because what we expect is price must move above or below the order block in order to take trading decisions, maybe selling or buying. We need to see price moving either above this, or price must move below this box. So when it moves out, it's when we will have a clear direction of the market. So we are still moving in for several days, and it is about weeks now. We are still moving in this box. So it shows that our price is creating a certain liquidity. So after that, it may leave powerfully to the upside or powerfully to the downside. But the direction that we are looking recently, it is an upward move, and it is in a correction mode, because a long-term direction, it is to the downside. And probably I can add this with our fundamentals, because we have a video. It's the third day now. Always you can watch that video. I talked about dimensions of analysis, and I talked about the fundamental analysis or fundamental dimension. I said that when you're analyzing market, you have to look on those three key dimensions. You have to look on fundamental, a technical, and what you call a sentimental. So now, based on technical, it's what I'm doing here. This is technical analysis. It shows that our price is going to move shortly to the upside. But based on fundamentals, you can check it in various FX calendars and everything. But also we have some informations now, some informations from Kitco. Now those who know the Kitco site, always this provide informations about metals and currencies sometimes. So now based on the fundamentals from Kitco, they show that gold is bearish unless they have information on this date, and also gold fundamentals are not bullish as usual. So now generally, and as I said, Fundamental, they provide us with a long-term direction of the market. A long-term direction of the market. So in a long term, gold is bullish. But this upward movement that I'm talking about here, it is just in the short term. That's why I say it is correction. So now, if that's the case, let's go on, I said that in 4 hours, I will have a wave count here. I'm going to provide a wave count whereby we already had an ABC to the upside. There's no problem with this. So if this was an ABC, it was just a beginning of correction. This was just a beginning of correction that we are looking about. And because it has not yet moved any distance to the upside, because our movement started there. So if we include Fibonacci tool here, Fibonacci retracement, you will find that it has not moved anywhere. So we expect at least to see it around 50 to 61 and maximum 78 maybe. So it has not yet moved anywhere now in a corrective mode. So we still look for this correction to go at least deeper to a certain level to the upside. So now, in terms of wave count, we have this ABC, the beginning of correction. Then after ABC, we have this 1, 2, 3, 4. It seems like a 5-wave move to the downside. So if it is a 5-wave to the downside, and this was ABC as a beginning of correction, therefore the whole structure here will be A. Then this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the downside will be the beginning of correction. So this is correction correcting a correction now. So it might be complicated, but the idea here is this is going to be A, and then we'll have B, finally maybe C to the downside in any way. We will have C to the downside in any way. Maybe we can put those waves there. We can put some waves there. So we'll have C to the downside. Now, completion of this C, it will be completion of wave B in high degree now. So this will be A. Now this will be B. And finally, we'll have C to the upside. Oh, there's rain outside. Oh, there's rain, it's raining. So we will have C to the upside. So if we expect to have that C to the upside, I can add degree there. This is in the highest degree. So if we are going to have C to the upside, always that's what we are looking now. We're supposed to see price moving at least to those levels there, up. Then after that, now direction to the downside will take place. So it is at least around those 184 or anything else, any level there. When I put that Fibonacci, I think we saw some key levels there. So we have to expect now this to take place. We have to expect this to take place. So probably next week it may move shortly to the upside, then shortly to the downside. Then let's expect a very powerful move to the upside now, probably after the coming week. After the coming week, we can have that. It depends on how fast the market is going to move. So now this is an overview, and mainly even in a hourly time frame, nothing important to add there. Nothing important. We must expect a very short move, a move to the downside, then a very strong move to the upside. So next week, tomorrow now, market may start with a very short move to the upside, then the coming days will have movement to the downside. So let's wait for what is going to happen. So thank you for your time now, and it is raining outside and actually it becomes very noisy. So thank you, and I think you will have at least a picture of what is expected to happen next week. So thank you, and keep in touch with Awesome Forex.